Hey plant fam, welcome back to the Botanic Blonde channel. Today we're going to be talking about my favorite three house plants of right now. Let's go! Alright, first up we have our Skindopsis Moonlight Trubii. This is a really great plant. It has these beautiful silvery leaves. And if it's allowed to grow in a hanging basket or off of a shelf, it will dangle in vine. This is native to Southeast Asia, New Guinea, Queensland, and certain Western Pacific Islands. If it is allowed to grow up a pole or a plank or wall, it will shingle. Really beautiful plant. This plant enjoys temperatures from 65 to 75 degrees. It can do a little bit more, should never be below 55. I have this one in a potting mix that I made myself. It needs to be well draining, but be able to hold its moisture pretty well. When I do water this plant, I thoroughly saturate the soil. I have it in a Kesh pot, in its original nursery pot. You want to thoroughly saturate that soil, but make sure it doesn't sit in water. As far as light goes, this plant enjoys bright but indirect light. A couple feet away from a south or western facing window would be ideal, where the natural light doesn't actually hit the leaves. This plant also can benefit from added humidity. They do like humidity. It will put out little aerial roots and nubs on these nodes if that is to happen, so they can climb. Alright, next up we have this lovely plant. I just love it. It is a Baronia prostrata, commonly known as a string of turtles. They grow in moist rainforest environments, so while most people like to let their peperomias dry out a little, I tend to water them before they're completely dried out. These ones are beautiful vining plant. In the right conditions, they will put out little aerial roots. And I'm assuming they could probably grow up a tree. I've never seen them in their natural habitat. They're very easy to propagate. If you guys want to know more about propagating, shoot me some comments and we can maybe shoot a video about propagating these and other plants. Peperomia prostrata does enjoy a little added humidity. It can do fine in a home environment without, but it likes it. They do also like bright but indirect light. You don't want to get direct light on this foliage because it will lose the fun little turtle pattern on the leaf. They are a semi-succulent leaf, so they're very thick and fat. They hold on to that moisture really well. Just a gorgeous, beautiful vining plant, and the pattern on these leaves is so much fun. You need fun. Last up, this has got to be one of my favorites. I ordered this beauty, Philodendron tortum, from a grower in Hawaii. I guess I shouldn't say I ordered it. I wanted it at an auction. They are starting to become a little bit more available, but you're still going to pay a bit of a premium. I've seen seedlings with two little baby leaves for about $85, all the way up to $750 for a mature plant. This baby I do have in a greenhouse cabinet. It loves humidity. When I first got it, I'd say 9 months, and it did nothing. No new leaves, but nothing died. And I stuck it in the cabinet, and I had a new leaf every 2 weeks. The fun thing about Philodendron tortum, besides the this is just such a fun plant. This will produce aerial roots given humidity. So it can grow up a totem or a pole. This is an intermediate philodendron. They're not the easiest, but they aren't the trickiest. They aren't a velvety leaf phyllo that really wants like tons of humidity. Like, these can do okay in most indoor environments. Once again, I'm in a very dry winter climate where I live, so I do stick it in my cabinet and it really enjoys it. Once again, I have this in a very chunky aeroid mix. It does hold some moisture, but you want it to be well draining. I like leaving mine in nursery pots, so that when you water them in their catch pot, you need to have it in that nursery pot or a drainage hole, so it's not holding moisture or getting those wet feet. They don't like that. This one is just absolutely gorgeous and one of my favorite plants I have right now. Thanks for joining us today while we talked about these three gorgeous houseplants that I absolutely love. If you have any ideas or would like to see any content from us, let us know in the comments. And of course, like the video, hit subscribe, and ring the bell. Thanks for joining us. Bye-bye.